The Gator Dashcam app for iOS and Android works in conjunction with all Wi-Fi enabled Gator Dashcams. It provides a simple and convenient way to configure your dashcam, playback footage, download recordings, and upload videos directly to YouTube, all from your smartphone or tablet. In this video, we're going to show you how to set up and use the app with your Gator Dashcam. First thing is to download the Gator Dashcam app. You can scan the QR codes on the screen now or search for Gator Dashcam on the Apple App Store or Google Play Store. I'll be using an Android device for this demonstration, but the steps are the same for Apple devices. Once downloaded, before we open the app, we must first make sure that your location services are turned on in your smartphone settings. The location of this setting may vary between different phones. Then make sure that your mobile data setting is turned off before opening the app. Once you have downloaded the app and have changed your phone settings, we can move on to pairing and connecting to your dashcam. Power on the Gator dashcam and navigate to your smartphone's Wi-Fi settings. You want to search for the Wi-Fi name that starts with the model number of your DVR. In this example, I'm using a GH-DVR-95W. So in the Wi-Fi, I would choose GH-DVR-95W followed by a string of numbers and letters that is unique to your dashcam. If you have not already paired with the dashcam before, it'll ask you for a password. The default password for Gator dashcams are typically 123456678 by default, unless changed prior with a previous app. Decline or ignore any message that pops up stating that there is no internet connection and to switch to mobile data. Make sure that your mobile data is also turned off, as that will interfere with the connection process. When successfully connected to the dashcam Wi-Fi, go back to the Gator dashcam app. In the bottom right corner, there is a plus button that will bring up the Pair New Device window. Since we're already connected to our dashcam, we can simply press the orange Wi-Fi button or the Copy Wi-Fi Name button to automatically copy the Wi-Fi name into the text field so you don't have to do it manually. You may be asked to allow some permissions, such as location, throughout using the app. For the password, we use the same password we use to connect to the dashcam's Wi-Fi. This is so the app will automatically connect to the dashcam without having to manually pair to it, as long as the dashcam is powered and in working order, by tapping the Save Dashcam in the main menu. Lastly, give it a name and tap Save. If you want to change the name or delete the saved dashcam, simply tap and hold the dashcam or press the three dots of the device you wish to modify, and a pop-up box will appear. Tapping on the dashcam you just created will automatically connect and show you the Live View section. Here we have a Live View button, some quick settings, and dashcam information at the bottom. Some of these settings may look different depending on the dashcam you are using. Pressing the Live View button will bring you to where you can see your front or rear camera. Pressing the camera button on the top right will change the view to your rear camera if your dashcam supports it. Pressing the X button will bring us back to the front page. Below the Live View button are some simple settings such as resolution, volume of dashcam, and toggle microphone recording. Pressing the cog at the top right corner will bring you to the advanced settings of the dashcam. Here's where you'll be able to change some of the more advanced settings and do actions like format the SD card and factory reset the device. Again, some of these settings will be different depending on the model dashcam you are using. Pressing the navigation menu in the top left corner, or sliding from the left, will show you the navigation menu. We'll get to some of the different options a little later, but first, if we want to access the recorded footage that's currently on the dashcam, we would click View Dashcam Files. You'll be presented with all the footage that's currently on your dashcam's internal storage. Tapping on a clip will open and automatically start playing. Up the top, we have drop-down list options for choosing which camera you want to view footage for, and on the right, what type of footage to show. This allows you to choose if you want to display only event footage or parking footage with the front or rear camera. The video icon up the top right will toggle between showing videos and images taken on your dashcam. The question mark icon will give you a quick rundown on how to download footage to your phone. So, to download footage onto your phone, we would tap and hold one of the clips until it turns orange. We can select other clips if we want to download more than one at a time. To deselect, it's a simple tap. You can press the download button in the bottom right to download the selected footage to your smartphone. Once your footage has been successfully downloaded, it is recommended to disconnect from your dashcam and connect to home Wi-Fi or mobile data before viewing your downloaded footage in order to use some of its features. To view footage that you downloaded, press the back button and select View Downloaded Files on the navigation menu. Here is where all the downloaded footage and images are stored from your various dash cams. Tapping on the file will bring it into view, where we can see the video being played, some video details, a share and upload button, and GPS breadcrumbing of your trip for dash cams that support this feature. The share button will allow you to send the file to different supported applications, such as Bluetooth and email. The upload button will upload the file onto YouTube if you've logged in, which I'll show how to do later. Selected Gator dash cams with the GPS feature have the ability to store date, start and end times, and distances from your road trips. To access this, tap the dash cam trips button on the navigation menu when connected to the dash cam to view the trips on that device. The maps button on the side will show you all the footage taken from that trip. So tapping on the Wednesday trip will show me all the footage from that day. Just bear in mind that if you've downloaded the footage in the View Dash Cam Trips section, then you'll need to go to the relevant trip in the View Downloaded Trips section to see your downloaded footage. It will not be in the View Downloaded Files. The Gator Dash Cam app also features the ability to upload your dash cam videos to YouTube. If not already, connect to the internet through home Wi-Fi or mobile data and log in with a Google account using the Login with YouTube button in the navigation menu. Once logged in, you can go to one of your downloaded footages and select Upload, which will bring up a dialog box giving the option to change the privacy settings of the video, the title, and description. Once the checkbox is ticked and you have tapped Upload, your selected video will be uploaded to your YouTube account and will provide you with a link to copy and paste on your phone. Just remember, you'll need to log in on your browser to view the video if you've set it into private. The Gator Dashcam app is available now to download on the Google Play Store and Apple App Store.